Thank you so much for coming in.
Yeah, thanks.
My name is Kiana, and I'm going to be talking to you today. Before we get started, I do want to go over some of the rules.
Okay.
I want you to be open and honest. You know, I want you to feel like you can talk to me about anything, because we do have some privacy things that I must tell you about. For one, whatever you tell me is going to stay between me and you. The only time I would have to break confidentiality if I suspect a child was being abused, or an elderly person, or the courts or someone requested the records.
Okay.
Is that okay with you?
Yeah, that works.
Okay, so tell me, what brings you in today?
So I have had a goal recently of cutting out snack foods from my diet, and it's something that I've struggled with a little bit. So I know that I'd really like to improve the way that I'm eating, but actually changing my habits has been a little hard.
Well, yeah, sounds like you said you had a hard time changing your habits, and we do know that everybody wants to be healthy, and cutting out the snacks is a healthy way.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me more about that.
Yeah, so my plan with this goal was really to focus on meal times, so kind of prepping meals and making sure that I'm eating things that are gonna, you know, fill me throughout the day, so that I'm not getting home and like going through the pantry and
yeah. So meal prepping is something that most definitely will help with that goal. Let me ask you this. I want you to think about this. On a scale of 1 to 10, how important is changing your eating habits to you?
I think that it's really important. So probably like a 7 for me.
You think it's a 7?
Mm-hmm.
And where do you think you are right now?
As far as adhering to that?
Mm-hmm.
That's probably a little bit lower, so probably like a 5.
So you chose a 7.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell me why you chose a 7 and not a 1?
Sure. So, kind of like I talked about before, I know that, you know, this will be something that will help my overall health, and I like to be active, and, you know, like my brother runs cross country, and so I like to go out and train with him, but I also, you know, get winded pretty easily. So in those ways, I know that it would help me a lot in activities that I like to do.
Yeah, so it sounds like you have motivation. You know, you want to be involved and active with your brother, so there's some motivation. What would not having any snacks, like just having your 3 meals a day, what would that look like for you?
So I think that it would be very important to make sure I'm getting those 3 meals and make sure that they are like nutritious things, because a lot of times I'll be running out of the house in the morning and skip breakfast.
Yeah.
And grab like random protein bars or different things for lunch, and just kind of be snacking throughout the day. And so I think that it would require probably some more prep than I'm putting in now, and definitely focusing on what foods are gonna fill me up.
Yeah, seems like you got a great plan. I do have this tool right here. It's called It Would Really Be Hard For Me.
Mm-hmm.
And we're gonna kinda like work on this together. So I want you to fill this out with as many sentences as you can. And it says, it would be really hard for me not to eat in between meals when. And just think about those times.
Okay. Thank you. I work with kids, so it's always a crowd favorite.
Yeah. Just let me know if you need any help. I'll do my best to, you know, guide you throughout this process.
Sure.
it would be really hard for me not to eat snacks in between meals when people around me are snacking. Can you talk a little bit about like the what about this people eating around you makes it hard?
I think I think of like when I have friends over and maybe we're watching a movie or doing something, and snacks are a big part of that. Like, I love to get my big bowl of popcorn, and that's kind of part of the socializing, you know, with friends, is the food is a part of it. And so I think it kind of feels like, I don't know, I have had those situations and have been sad to miss out on that part of it.
So what about missing out on the snacking is a problem for you?
I think it's it kind of feels like an inconvenience. Like, I know that I shouldn't have these snacks right now, but I also know that the people around me are and they're having a great time. So it's kind of those two things are battling.
So we know that when people are going to be around us and we're going to snack, what can you do to resist those temptations? How can you prepare yourself for that?
I probably could be upfront with them and let them know, like, hey, I'm trying to do this, and see if they could, you know, alter what they were doing. But at the same time, I wouldn't really want to affect, you know,
somebody else.
Yeah. So maybe really focusing in on those meals that I am having for that day. So
yeah.
Planning something that I really like to eat for my dinner that night or something like that.
Or you could eat ahead, you know, because if you're already full, you might not want a snack.
Sure.
Let's look at number two. Number two says, it would be really hard for me not to snack in between meals when people offer me food, such as birthdays, special events.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's a really good one. Talk to me more about this.
Yeah. So I feel like there's still some of those, like, feelings of missing out for that one. So it was recently my brother's birthday, and everybody was eating their cake, and I felt like, you know, I didn't want to be rude when it was offered to me, and so there were some things, like some social things about it, that you know, it's just normal for everybody to have a slice of cake at a birthday, and I didn't really want to go against the norm.
Yeah, sounds like you are a people pleaser and want to make people happy, but at the same time, you have goals that you're trying to establish for yourself.
Yeah.
All right, let's look at number three. Number three says, when you're stressed at work, what does stress at work look like for you?
So that really, I feel like, happens when there's a lot going on, when my calendar is full and I'm not able to, you know, get everything checked off like I want it.
And the last one, number four, says, when you're not prepared, you miss breakfast, you don't have time for dinner until after class.
Mm-hmm.
What can you do to be better prepared to not miss out on this one? Okay, so what strategies or things can you put in place to make sure that you don't miss out on breakfast and you are able to hold your hunger over until after class?
So I think the breakfast is easier because I know what I need to do. I just sometimes don't do it. So that would be making my meal beforehand, so the night before, kind of getting that ready so that it's something easy where I just, you know, have to heat it up in the morning.
Yeah.
Because I'm not a morning person, so I you know, I have enough self-awareness to know that I'm not going to, like, make eggs or do something in-depth in the morning. It needs to be something quick that I can.
Well, Lauren, it sounds like you have a lot of strategies. You know, you talked about, you know, wanting to eat healthier to make sure that you didn't eat in between meals, cutting out all the snacks. You seems like you have some strategies for when you are around people mm-hmm. and they come to your house and, you know, avoiding all the popcorn and everything. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so that's all the time we have today. So
okay.
We'll continue this our next session and keep up the good work.
Okay, thank you.
I hope that was 10 minutes.